हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू डे 31st ऑफ जनवरी लीग को चैलेंज 100 डेज क्वेश्चन एंड नेक्स्ट परमिटेशन. इन दिस क्वेश्चन यू आर गिवन एन एरे विच रिप्रेजेंट्स अ पर्टिकुलर नंबर. यू नीड टू जनरेट द नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट हायर नंबर दैट कंटेन्स अ सिमिलर नंबर ऑफ डिजिट्स एज दैट आर गिवन इन दिस एरे. सो लेट्स टेक वन एग्जाम्पल हेयर. इन दिस केस द नंबर इज 123. वट विल बी द नेक्स्ट हायर नंबर दैट कैन बी जनरेटेड using the digits that are present in this number 1, 2 and 3, it is 132, and hence the answer becomes 1, 3, 2. So the array is just a way of representing the digits of the number, although the number was 123 that was given to you. For the case where you are given the highest number, in that case you need to give the lowest one, because there is no greater number that is possible that can be generated using these digits. In that case, you need to give the one which has the lowest value, 123 in this case. Let's go with this case, 115. The next higher number will be 151, and this is what we have written as an output. If the number is 1, then it is the highest number that can be generated. Therefore, we will return the one with the lowest value, which is again 1 in this case. So, if you understood the question carefully, you will realize that we did a similar kind of a question in 2020, in the last month of 2020. Although 2020 is nothing worth remembering, but we will remember it for the learning that we have done. We did a question named Next Greater Element 3, and it is an exact replica of this question. I would recommend you guys to look at its video. I'm attaching the video from here, and so that because the concept is eventually the same. If you can recall that video, it's well and good. Otherwise, I'm attaching the video from here. So let's go back in past and let's see. Hello everyone, welcome to day 23rd of December Lead Code Challenge, and today's question is Next Greater Element 3. In this question, you are given a number and you need to identify the next smallest number that can be generated from the existing digits of n. If there is no such number that is possible, then you would have to return -1. For example, let's take 21. This is a maximum number that can be generated using these two digits, 2 and 1. Hence, there is no next higher number using the same digits. You return -1. For example, when the case is 12, the next higher number would be 21, and you generated this. One possible way of solving this question is to generate all the possibilities of the number using the current number, and you then find the iterate through the loop and check for the next higher number out of the lot. However, this is a poor man's algorithm. We'll not go with this approach. We will try to do something in a smarter way. So let's look at the algorithm now. Also, it's a very commonly asked question in the interviews, whether it's Amazon, whether it's Adobe, whether it's Microsoft, whether it's Netflix. It's one of the favorite pet questions that is often asked across the interviews. So it's kind of a tricky too, that you need to know the approach beforehand. If you know it, you'll be able to solve it. If you don't know it, it will be slightly difficult for you to think during the interview for the first time. So let's look at the algorithm now. So 1, 2, 4, 5 is the input number in this case, and the next higher number that can be generated is 1, 2, 5, 5, 4. The role is of only these two numbers, 4 and 5, which get reversed to 5, 4. Let's look at the next part. 1, 2, 4, 5, 1. In this case, next higher number would be 1, 2, 5, 1, 4. So the play is of these two numbers, 4, 5, and 1. Carefully observe what is happening. So there's an increasing path, 1, 5, and then there is a decreasing path. You need to find the immediate higher number, and you have to do some operation on these three numbers to get your output number. So let's look at the algorithm in this case. So if you look at the number 1, 2, 5, 4, 3, 1, the next higher number is 1, 3, 1, 2, 4, 5. So if you carefully observe, that this is an increasing series from the backward direction till the time you get this index. So as soon as you get this index, you note this index. Let's call this my F index, that is the first swap index, index to be swapped. With which value it is to be swapped, let's iterate through in the backward direction again, and let's see, find the first higher number than this number. The first higher number would be 3 here. So this becomes the second swap index, SS. So you swap these two and you get 1, 3, 5, 4, 2, 1. And what are you going to do next? You need to reverse this part of the string, this part of the number, because you are interested in finding the smallest value, next smallest number, not something that is greater, way greater. Hence, once you have found out the higher number at the point of deflection, which is 3 in this case, you need to reverse the other part of the number, and what you will get, 1, 3, 1, 2, 4 and 5. So this is what the logic says. First of all, the first step is to identify the point of deflection. How do you identify the point of deflection, which is this? You start from the end of the string, the end of the number, and you keep on traversing till you don't find a point of deflection as soon as the value decreases. At any point, note this point at the first swapping point. Then again iterate through the number list, and you get 1, 3. Find out the number with which it is to be swapped. You find out the second swapping point. You swap these two numbers, and you just reverse the remaining part of the number, and you concatenate the number again and form the number. So 1, 3, this is how you get 1, 3, 1, 2, 4, 5. So this is a three-step process. Hope I'm able to explain this three-step process. And whenever there is no point of deflection in the number, since it's an increasing sequence from the backwards, if you reach zeroth index, that means you are done. That's the maximum number that can be generated. You return minus 1 out of it. Similarly, for this case, you return minus 1 out of it since there is no.
Hope you enjoyed that session and understood the algorithm. There was slight difference between that question and this question. For the case where you're already given the highest lexicographical number, in that question you had to return minus 1. In this question, you will have to return the smallest number that can be generated, the digits in a sorted fashion. So with this handling, let's code it up. So let's start with the process defining an integer index for the first reversal as first, and let's initialize it to nums dot length minus 1, while first is greater than equal to 1, and nums of first minus 1 is greater than equal to nums of first. I am searching for the first index that will be a possible contender for the swap, reducing the first index. And if for the case first becomes equals to 0, that means it is already sorted, and I'll return from here after sorting the elements. So arrays dot sort first. Otherwise, I will reduce first by one point, because that is the actual index, not first minus one. The first point of deflection is this. And let's start with the second part, where I'm searching for the second index that needs to be swapped. Nums dot length minus 1, while second is greater than first, and nums of first is greater than equal to nums of second. Second minus minus. And once I have these two indexes, I need to reduce second by one more time for the case that will actually be the contender for the second index. And once I have done that, I'll swap the nums part with the first index and the second index, writing the helper method. if first is not equal to second, storing it in a temporary variable, basic swap method. Hope you are able to recall all of this from the past. So far we are good. And let's perform the reverse sorting operation. From which index we will start? First plus 1. What will be the end index? Nums.length minus 1. And while start is less than end, storing the swapping in the reverse order, just reversing the array from the start position till the end. Pretty simple way to reverse the number in an array. And now what will I do? End minus minus, start plus plus, and simply we are done. We don't need to return anything. Everything will be handled. And let's try this up. Oh, arrays dot sort not first but nums. There was a slight mistake that I made. This second variable should not be there. It is already being handled by this while loop. I added an extra reduction in the second index that was causing an issue. If you remove this, it's well and good. Let's try this up. Looks fine, and let me just submit this. Accepted. Let me just walk you through the code again. What we are doing, we are finding the first point of deflection, the point of deflection. How? Till the time nums of f first minus 1 is greater than nums of first, we keep on reducing the first index. And for the case we have reached the 0th index for first, that means the array is already sorted in decreasing order. We need to return the lowest number that can be generated. Hence, I sorted this using array the sort method and returned aborted the process. Otherwise, I reduced the first to another one more time so that I reached the index where I actually need to swap the numbers. Now I start calculating for the second index. It initialized to the extreme right corner. Till the time first is less than second, till the time first index is less than second and nums of first is greater than nums of second, I keep on reducing the second index. Once that process is over, I swap first with second, and for the rest of the part I reverse, starting from first plus one index till the end, I reverse all the elements in that in half part of the array in the subset of an array starting from the first plus one position, and that's it. This is pretty much how we wrote the code. The time complexity of this approach is order of n. You can improvise this and instead of using arrays of sort method, you can simply reverse all the elements because the number is already there in the decreasing order. Lexicographically, the highest number that can be generated using the same digits, and you can remove the sorting logic and write the code by yourself for reversing the array completely, and then the complexity will become order of n, and space complexity is constant. So one work for you is to write this by yourself using the same logic as what you have written here. In that case, the start will be from the 0th index instead of first plus 1. Thanks for watching this. Hope you enjoyed it.